When we use the iPad to watch Netflix, project to this TV screen wirelessly, what do we usually do? Very simple. Our usual practice is to pull it down. Then there is this symbol of wireless projection here. Press it, but you will find you can only see the screen of this iPad desktop. But when you open the Netflix app, you will find that it is strange why there is no image. It turns out, years ago, Netflix has something for this AirPlay. The way this projection blocked, that is to say, you and wirelessly connect your iPad, stream Netflix wirelessly to this TV, will be locked. It's invisible. Is there any way to solve it? Of course there is. Because Netflix only targets wireless projection, it does block. Then it is not for this wired. This USB hub. If you are afraid, you just use the original Apple USB-C to HDMI and USB hub. You connect it, then connect the HDMI to the TV. Like this at this time. The iPad screen will be projected to the TV. Let's open this app Netflix open. Then open it. Play a video. You see no problem. You can see that there is no problem with video and sound. Then you hear that everyone thinks it as wrong. Then why is this in my house? It is impossible to convert the physical USB-C to HDMI cable. It is possible that you are using this line. This kind of line is about 200 to 300 yuan. Then why doesn't this line work? This is what we just saw is a USB-C hub. It is the physical HDMI output. But this cable, well, although you look like a solid cable, but it's not a real entity. Let's actually connect once to show you. You know what you're talking about. Let's power it with the USB of this line first. Then what? You connect your transmission cable to this USB. If you're a Lightning iPad, just use Lightning's transmission cable. USB-C iPad uses USB-C cable. Okay, connect. I'll connect this iPad and show you. Then you see this. Prompt symbols for trust and distrust. Okay, then you just trust. Then type your password. This is not the so-called physical HDMI output. So-called physical HDMI output. USB-C hub is the same. After plugging it in, then what? The HDMI cable connected to this TV will have a picture. But there is one more step. It's like manual trust or distrust. It's called insubstantial. When my iPad or iPhone, after the transmission line of the sub factory connected, I just pressed trust and distrust. After I press trust, then the video is projected onto this TV screen. Then I open this Netflix and you will find that it only black screen. Take a look. Dial to see. You see it just rolls around, rolls around, rolls around. It can't dial out. That's it. There is another way of projection is hub like this. He is after powering him. Although he will not show any trust or distrust, but he will ask you to do something. I'll show you. Then here is the HDMI output. How does he want HDMI output? He has to pull it down manually. Then press this to project to this device. Press this place. Go down. Only then will the screen jump to your TV. You see it will come out like this. In this way, then I open this Netflix again for the same reason. This. Play him roll like this. Only sound, no image. Look like this. Well, I just did two things. One is trust and distrust. The other is to press the projection action. Of course, it cannot be regarded as a physical HDMI output. In fact, he still uses this kind of AirPlay. Technical category. So what we really have to use is this one. The real physical USB-C hub can be used. Let's summarize what we just said. We just said that we need physical HDMI output. The so-called physical HDMI output is not that he grows up. There is a physical HDMI output here. Means when that, like this original device after connecting to the iPad, he's actually appearing on TV. Then you see, although this type has a physical HDMI output interface, the problem is, you are on your iPad. How do you trust or distrust? Or the action of pressing the projection. This is one more process. It's not an entity anymore. Okay, Let's talk more professionally. With physical HDMI output for a PC hub, it is to comply with the so-called DP out mode. Such a hub can be connected to this USB-C iPad. The iPad still has some hairy places. Your USB-C iPad. If you are using CPU, use this M1 CPU. That may not be able to project. So I suggest you, in order not to get entangled in these things, you can directly use this original Apple. The hub of the original USB-C is guaranteed to be no problem. You can never say the results from the original factory cannot be projected by themselves. You just buy the original anyway. Then you buy this so-called DP out mode USB-C hub. You have to think about saying this. Is your iPad Pro USB-C version M1 CPU? M1 CPU is not acceptable. Then this is. So be careful with this. Pay special attention. Okay, what are we going to talk about next? Connecting to TV is easy because the TV does not have the so-called HDCP problem. TV it is display device. Will not do some copy actions, so no problem. Then our next stage is to say that this iPad connect to the apps of this computer. Then do this video recording action. Then everyone will be very curious. That is, this HDMI from the original factory. Does it have HDCP or not? Is there or not? Snort. Here we will share with you in detail. What we do is absolutely legal. The capture card I took is guaranteed to be a capture card without HDCP cracking. Then the experiment you are waiting for will surprise you. Next, I'm going to transfer the Netflix video to the iPad via video capture card. This computer OBS. I used to video capture cards. Neither of these two video capture cards has HDCP cracking. I use legal methods here to settle this matter. This is a full HD video capture card. When the HDMI is connected to the video capture card, my full HD video capture card, he has so-called EDID will tell that this device says, hey, please drop full HD over here. Well, this is the first one. The second one is a 4K video capture card. It is Yuengang's 4K video capture card. When the HDMI source of this iPad, when I received this video capture card, the EDID of the video capture card will tell the iPad that, please show me 4K. So what's the problem? Neither of the two HDCPs were cracked. Let's experiment and show you. First, connect this 1080p. Our company's early video capture card connected to the computer. Then connect the HDMI source to this. Then turn on the OBS of this computer and open it. Then go to this FABN168. You can see the picture. Okay, then I'll dial this Netflix again for you to watch. This. Play. There's a sound, look. Good thing there is a video. Then I will change it now. Replace it with this VR Media 4K, so it can be connected. 4K video capture card. Then I connect its video source. Then open this OBS. See, there is no video. You can see the screen. Oh, look. Okay, tell me, is the video capture card connected wrong? No, I'll broadcast something for you once. I'll show you the camera. Camera, this is a normal camera. You see no problem. There is a picture. Then you see, connect this screen to this iPad. No. That's the same reason. I'm using an iPhone now. You can use the original iPhone. After the Lightning to app adapter is plugged in, then I first received a full HD video capture card. No HDCP cracking. Come in. Then open this OBS. You see there is a video. And then dial this Netflix. You see no problem with sound and video. What happens to 4K capture cards without HDCP cracking? It is the same. It is the screen or it can't come out. Can't get out. Do you find it very interesting? Both are uncracked HDCP video capture cards. One is a full HD video capture card. One is a 4K video capture card. Can't catch one. Can't capture 4K. Full HD capture card can catch it. It's explained like this. When your iPad or iPhone, this HDMI output is connected to a 4K video capture card. 4K video capture card will tell him, hey, please throw me 4K. Then he knew and said, hey, I'm going to lose 4K. Then he put this 4K. The HDMI packs his HDCP into it. So his HDMI output is good with HDCP. What about this one? He said, come, please lose that 4HD HDMI to me. At this time, he wanted to say, 4HD is okay. Then what? His HDMI comes out without HDCP protection. Like this, you will feel very blind. When you stream Netflix with this iPad iPhone, when HDMI output, it may not have HDCP protection. If the previous video capture card, when using a 4HD video capture card to capture, then this iOS system will throw this un-HDC protected HDMI out. So is your Netflix. It's like having no protection. But if you use this 4K capture card to pick up, this 4K capture card told him, please throw out this 4K HD. Then this iOS will put the HDMI of HDCP to add in. Only then will your Netflix be protected. Is there any way not to be a capture card for HDCP cracking and then 4K again? Of course there is a way. Like our company this one. Everyone thought that he had cracked HDCP. Actually no. How did you do it? It's easy. I'll tell you the secret. Very simple. Although it is 4K, but my edit is lost to this iPad or iPhone is 4HD. So this iPad iPhone in front, he thought I was a 4HD capture card, so I'll be able to fetch. But can this camera do 4K capture? Of course you can. Although I lost this 4HD edit, this front device is not necessarily necessary. Lost 4HD, this device can also be manually set to 4K output. For example, some multimedia player can manually output to 4K. At this time, I can still capture 4K like this. Make him a 4HD EDID. Tell everyone, the advantage is that this iPhone, he will throw out the picture quality of 4HD. That in fact, your iPad or iPhone you use HDMI output, you can only lose the HDMI video format of 4HD. You don't need to throw this 4K EDID to him. So you just change EDID to 4HD. You can do 4HD EDID. If you do this, you can use it without cracking it. HDCP way to successfully capture this Netflix video for iPhone or iPad is legal because I didn't crack HDCP. The same reason I put this original Lightning Figure AB converter to HDMI connected to this capture card of our company Fabon 17 Night Plus. It doesn't have HDCP crack, it just added its 4HD. Then after coming in, let's see if OBS will have a screen to open. Oh, do you see the picture? Then I turn on Netflix. I didn't crack it at all. Just change the edit to 4HD. You see there are pictures and images. There is sound. Then this is the iPad with USB-C. Then I use this original USB-C to the hub. Connect it in the same way. At this time, OBS will have a screen. Wait a moment. Look at the picture. And then I dial up Netflix. About this Netflix on this iPad or iPhone. Projected to this TV screen. This Netflix, he put an end to using this AirPlay path. That is to say, you cannot directly use your wirelessly. The iPad is projected directly onto this. But he didn't say he would lock other wired way. That's some way. For example, like this iPad USB-C version. Just use a USB-C hub. Well, if you are really afraid of coming and going. For example, if you are struggling, you can buy Apple Made. The Apple Made kit. This hub of USB-C to HDMI can definitely be used. That it can guarantee. You can use some way to connect to the TV. If it's an iPhone, then you buy this Lightning to app adapter. Guaranteed you can make this Netflix on iPhone, projected to this TV screen. Then come again, I want to say that TV is easy to deal with. It's because the TV doesn't have HDAD. The more difficult thing is how to convert your screen to this iPhone. Throw it on the OBS of this computer for processing. Do Louis we adopt is justifiable. This capture card does not crack HDCP. Well, I just did an experiment. Just use this 4HD capture card and this 4K capture card. Just very funny. For your 4HD capture card, EDID in 4HD, tell the iPhone to ask you to throw a 4HD video. At this time, your iPhone won't do any HDCP encryption. On the contrary, if you use this 4K capture card, he will tell the EDID of the 4K capture card to the iPhone. Please throw me 4K. This is the iPhone operating system, iOS operating system. He will say, let me help you encrypt HDMI and add HDCP protection. At this time, this 4K capture card, you can see it in legal mode. Of course, why do you lose 4K EDID? So our company has made a 4K capture card. We don't leave. We don't add 4K EDID. Let's throw 4HD EDID to this iPhone. Then he received the same. He thought I was a 4HD capture card in the front. The same can be intercepted. I'm totally in legal mode. I didn't lie to him. He is legal because he doesn't lose his iPhone. This HDMI with HDCP. Can't blame me. So we're going the legal way. Of course our capture card is real 4K. If your source, he forced to throw out 4K, I can take it too. No problem.